And it's done. Well, it's end of the season and time for me to do a little bit of lessons learned. Sadly, there's not much that I can say that I learned through my garden this year. These pineapple tomatillos in the containers actually did okay. They didn't produce all that great, and I am really thinking that it's because of the containers that I had. They were too small. But they actually did better than the other ones as far as production, because they were over here in the sun. Maybe next year I'll try some more of these in larger pots and probably try to make them the air pruning pots. Garden is being taken down now. The exploding cucumbers I had, it's getting too cold now. We're having frost. I never got a video of one of them exploding, but it's just getting too cold for it to get to that point, I guess. And it had taken over this entire fence. So I've got it down. I ran over it with a lawnmower. It's in the compost bin. Same thing with my beans, got them down. Also my tomatillos. Now here's lesson learned about our tomatillos, that I really think that I should maybe put tomato cages around them. Here's the other ground cherries or pineapple tomatillos. The plants themselves grew very well right here. Had lots of blooms, but it didn't get as much sun because they got a little bit of too much shade. I think that might be what the problem was there. Not real sure, but the plant itself grew very, very well, and I think maybe if they grow like this for me again, I'm definitely going to be growing the pineapple tomatillos again. That I'm definitely thinking tomato cages around them, because that is only three plants right there, and I actually cut quite a bit out of there yesterday. Peas, I got these are mangotalp peas. I put them in to see if they'd do well for fall, and they did well. I was actually surprised. But as far as lessons learned from my garden, there's really not much. My soil building efforts, I think, did very well. I did have good, healthy plants, and the only fertilization I did was nettle tea fertilizer that I fermented and set out, and things did very, very well. But the greatest lesson learned that I had this year really had to do more with time management and prioritization. I had a lot of outside influences this year, some of which I had no control over. Others, I could have looked at them and said, now wait a minute, you can do it. You got more time than me. Get on it. And I didn't. But yeah, time management and prioritization has been my greatest problem ever since January, and mostly due to outside influences. I had a lot of work planned up on our little property to try to turn it into a little small working homestead without a home. But it was very difficult to get to it. I have already earmarked several items that are going to be going away, such as my one of my part-time jobs is going to go away. We did a little bit of analyzation looking at our budget, and we figured out that after expenses for this job, I was bringing home very, very little. Not much at all. I knew it wasn't going to be much in the first place, but I didn't realize it was going to be that little. And then further evaluation of our budget, we realized that even though I would be making less money overall with my other part-time job, I would actually be bringing home more money. Not much more money, but we would actually be bringing home more money. Plus, that would be freeing up another two whole days that I could spend on our homestead. Our little homestead property is my major priority. This is mine, my major priority for me and my family. It's actually taken me 5 years to get my wife get in line with that. But she's beginning to see the advantage of all of this. Because she handles the budget for the most part. So she sees how much money we're saving on food by us working this garden. And she now sees the advantage of actually turning it into a homestead. So I'm very, very thankful that, you know, she's always been supportive, but she is now finally completely on board with the idea of a small homestead. She is even now talking about wanting to find some property out in the country and doing a real homestead. Oh, I was about to do backflips when she said that. But time management and prioritization is the thing that has hit me the hardest this year. So I just like to encourage you, even though you may feel like you're doing well on it, at least once a month, sit down and reevaluate everything you're doing. Because that is something that I'm ashamed to say that I did not do this year. I normally do that. Is once a month looking at everything that I did the month before, looking at everything I'm planning for the month ahead, and reevaluating my prioritizations. Just like to encourage you, even if you think you're doing really good, take a little time, look at it, and just see if you might be able to do a little better.